good price of the airport for must be financial minus the density to the state. Otherwise, there will be arbitrage opportunities and the model will not be there. So now, as you can see, this is the global zero report. So this is a nice assumption for the mathematical purpose. This is not a nice assumption for reality because there are not very, many defaultable zero coupons and it will be difficult to calibrate the model with defaultable zero coupons. The data is too spare. And in order to calibrate the data, we have to go to CPCs or other financial protections that are trademarked. Defaultable coupons, maybe defaultable coupons are traded when it's a default is a default of the state. But if it is a default of the firm, usually you don't have defaultable zero coupons with respect to the firm. So assume that it is defaultable zero coupons. Something we pay one monetary unit and one capital T, if capital T is the default and not a real default time capital. I assume that. And I assume that the market maker is the price for this asset. Of course, I think quite difficult dynamics. Here I assume, again, it's a toy model, so I should assume that the dynamic is as simple as possible. So I should assume that the price of the default number 0.2, so this asset is 3-1 at maturity and the default is not 2, and 0 is what, nothing else, the recovery that you get, is something similar to that one. With a time, which is deterministic. This is an assumption. Strong. But since this is the default number 0.2, after time tau, the value of the defaultable is zero. If tau is occurred 2 days ago, I should not get the promised payoff. So this is why I am giving an indicator function. So this quantity is this exponential if t is smaller than tau, otherwise this is zero. So this is an assumption. And I would like to do something. Forget about that. I should not use that now. I should do that to next time. I assume that phi is deterministic and I just know something I can prove in my models later on, but something which is intuitive. Just think, should base this defaultable zero coupon. And the market contains the default-free zero coupon, this one. I don't want to pay this defaultable coupon higher than the price of the default-free zero coupon, otherwise it would be stupid. I can get for sure one monetary unit. I should not pay more to get maybe one monetary unit. So this price must be smaller than the point here. So the size must be bigger than that. In all the models, if I try to write a model, if this property is not satisfied, so there is some arbitrage in the model, that's not a good idea. Forget that. Okay. And the goal is to try to add to something a very intuitive level. I should give a proof of that later on. So I would like to add, that is to construct in the market, by assume that in the market there is a defaultable zero coupon and a default-free zero coupon. These are the only two assets. And I would like to construct with these two assets a portfolio. The terminal value of the portfolio will be H2. H2 is paid at time capital T. Usually I know that the story is paid very often at time 2. Here, to a simple model, I should explain why next time. I assume that the H2 is paid at time 2. And I would like to show you that we can edge this market. So in other terms, some people in the audience ask me questions, and we'll be in a complete market. This can edge perfectly the edge of two. So I will be in what we call a complete market. Usually in model with default free, with defaultable asset, I'm complete. Here I will be in a complete market. I can edge perfectly all the random things I have. And in my toy model, I have a lot of randomness. Only two is random. So the only random things are functions of two. And not anything else. The certain age, any age to obey that I told, the market will be what it would be. I do some questions, so I shall answer to that question here. I had a question about what is the risk control probability measure and so on. So here, the risk control probability measure will depend on the assumption I should do here. And what is the meaning of far and the risk probability I could use the far. I will come back to that. So, I do psychometric evaluation on portfolio. So I construct the portfolio with 5-0 share of the developable 0.2 and 5-1 share of the developable 0.2. So the value of the portfolio is 5-0 number of shares of the underlying of the defaultable 0.2 IF times the price of 0.2 plus 5-1 T number of shares of defaultable 0.2 that I had in my portfolio. By a the price of one check. And then I assume that L equals 0. I can do the same where L is the to modify it. So now I use the self-identity condition. And the self-identity condition means that if the value of the portfolio changes, the value of the portfolio is just due to the change of the prices. And not to the pre-balancing portfolio. Like if you change your mind about 5-0 and 5-1, you do not change the value of the portfolio. So, and usually when you have DT equal 5-0, sorry, DT equal 5-0 T, usually it's E to the power of minus 8T plus 5-1 T S-1 T, where S is some asset, c'est le domaine de Brandon Beauchamp. And the meaning is that the value of the portfolio change only if the prices change. And there is no D pi 0 and no D pi 1. So here, the self-financing. So I took R equals 0, so if the R is equal to 0, e to the power Ft is 1, and the differential is 0. This is pi and t, dx is. I choose R equals 0, this is why I simplify it. So the self-financing condition is that. And now, what is the a gift is that in this kind of model where there are adjuncts, in fact it is easy to guess the solution. To prove the solution is more difficult. But to guess the solution is quite easy because the processes you handle are nice processes except that there are some jobs. So, yeah. So now, come back here, the VT is 5-0T, 5-0T is a no, one moment, 5-1T, D, T. So assume that 5-0 and 5-1 are nice processes. This value has to jump, because the D has to jump. I assume that 5-1 and 5-0 are continuous. The only jump is here. So this V has only one jump at time 2, and the jump is given by this quantity times the jump of that quantity D. And the jump of D is easy. It's given here. The D is equal to that quantity, and then suddenly the D goes to 0. So the jump of D is 0, the value after the jump, minus the value before the jump, if the jump occurs at tau equals. So this is 5-1, the jump of the is t equals. So, and from here, I would like that to be equal to x squared. So at that tau, the v is a jump, which is the value of the tau, and the value of the tau will be x tau, minus the value before tau, and the value before tau is what I call v minus, is the value just before tau. I don't know what it is for the moment, but this is the value just before tau. And I know what I got. So the two jumps will be equal, this jump will be equal to that one, for tau, but tau is a random variable. The only one on the variable, the ones all the quantities are deterministic. So if you have two functions which are equal at time tau, g of tau is equal, say f of tau. And where is g of tau omega equal f of tau omega? If tau is random variable, you can take any value between 0 and infinity, it means that g is equal to f. Omega by omega is equal to 0. So tau of omega can take any value between 0 and infinity. So if g of tau is equal to f of tau, it means that g as a function is equal to l to f as a function. So I do the same here. So I guess what is the time of? If this equality must be true at time tau, by definition, it must be equal to that value at time tau by definition, so I get the pi 1 for any t. And this is something which at first look can be surprising, because the pi 1 is very easy to find. And this is just the value after the jump minus the value of the jump. And here I have to discount by this d tau, t capital T. So it means that, of course, we have to check that all the same. We have to do the right for this. But it means also, it's important, but this for me, is that even if you have some Bohmian motion, even value of the firm and whatever, if you would like to edge the defaultable part, usually it's easy to find exactly the edging engine portfolio. And fully different from the Brownian case. Brownian case, we have no way to find the delta engine, except if you are in the Markov model, in the Dachshund model, and so on. Otherwise, we have no way, no mathematical way, to directly find the value of the engine portfolio. Here, more or less, always the same story. If we see that on some example, you can guess, and this is it, the nice result, you can get the Eiffel strategy. So I showed about this generalization, I should come back on that for the next lecture. And now I would like, during the last part of that lecture, to speak about structural models. So I would like to speak about structural model, maybe just opportunism. The first one is that this is the historical model. So sometimes we have to look at historical model. The second reason is that this is a good model. This is a good model because I can explain for an economic meaning where the default is coming from. For me, if I can get the other model, the default came from the blue sky. There will be no economic reason for the other model. That one, you have an economic reason, that's not enough. And if you would like more to talk to one model, you ask to be a specialist of structural models. So you can see, since this is a good model, why am I choosing that model and devote the lecture to that structural approach? So I should give immediately the result. The first reason is that I am not strong enough in mathematics to solve the problem used with this kind of model. Because if you use this kind of model, you have to find the law of some random time, and I am unable to find the law, except in very specific cases, I am unable to find the law of this random time. So I am unable to find it. It was one for me. This is a good reason at least for me. For everybody. You can say you can do approximation, you can do simulation, whatever. The other is on, I can explain it later.
Oh, can you explain it just now?
No. The other reason, and this is more serious, is that it does not give good calibration measures. And I should explain more. Mm-hmm. This is the main reason. And the third reason is that the model is based on some assumption, mathematical assumption, or financial assumption, and these assumptions are not realistic. So at least they are. Forget the first one, but the point is just gives my interest. The two other reasons are good reasons for the content. So this is called structural approach in the literature. And in the literature, there are two approaches. I disagree with these two approaches, and with that too. You see, either a structural approach, either another approach, I fully disagree with that difference, because they are both the same thing, but this is what people do. So what is the structural approach? So the first one, the structural approach, is due to Merton. So I guess you know the name of Merton. Merton is part of the Black-Scholes-Merton formula, and he got the Nobel Prize for his work on the optimization portfolio and this kind of thing. And he had in mind to evaluate the defaultable asset in a very specific model, but quite interesting. So, Merton claimed that we should take the value of the flow, so that Vt is the value of the flow, at Lt. And we should say that the firm entered, the firm extracted some product, and the terminal payoff is capital L. So the firm is promised to deliver capital L, as we take capital L constant, capital L at maturity at time capital T. But maybe the firm is not able to give you capital L. And why the firm is not able to give you capital L? Because the value of the firm is smaller than capital L. So the value of the firm is greater than capital L, so receive capital L. If the value of the firm is smaller, assume as in the Merton model, after that you can add a lot of things, the value of the firm will be depleted, and you will receive only the value of the firm. So you will receive Vt, the value of the firm, if the value of the firm is smaller than L, and N, if the value of the firm is greater than L. This is the Merton model, very simple, maybe a little bit naive, but it doesn't matter. Just explain what is the idea. And so explain what he has to do. So, the defaultable, if I would like to write the defaultable, not done in Merton, if I would like to write the defaultable as a type, I have to say the defaultable is a random variable, which is equal to T, the default, if Vt is smaller than L. And otherwise, whatever you want, the plus affinity for capital T plus 1, it doesn't matter, if the value of the firm is greater than L. The defaultable is just either capital T, maturity, or something after capital T. So this payoff can be written, it's useful to do the computation so that we can't do the computation. And this quantity can be written as the minimum between Vt and L. This is exactly what I've written here in mathematics, called test. I should receive either L or Vt, whatever is the minimum, whichever is the minimum. And you can write that as L minus the maximum between L minus Vt is 0. So it's a bit ugly. But this is useful because now you can write that as L minus the positive part of capital L minus Vt. So for those of you who are not familiar with that, Merton did that because this quantity is a good assumption of the value of the firm, and under more assumption, you can do the computation. But it's not because it's a wonderful algebraic formula, it's just because the computation of that quantity is well known. You can find it in any textbook. Why the computation of the expectation of this quantity and the quantity find the right person is very good and receive and get it. So, now yesterday assumption, it would be a nice model to find this quantity for any assumption on the value of the curve. But it's not doable. You know that you can find the value of a put in black sort of model, in some other model, in the general model, you are able to do that. So, method postulate for all the assumptions we need to be able to compute this expectation loss Vt minus of A minus V. So the first assumption is to have a constant interest rate.
You
can compute this quantity. Again, this is well known if you are doing that's also formula. You can compute this quantity. So this is something ugly, but you can compute it explicitly. So this gives you the probability that the difference occurs at time capability. And so this quantity, not the minus one, this quantity, so this quantity will correspond to the probability of it greater than n. This quantity is called the distance to default. Because it's a measure of how far you are from the default. And this quantity will give you the probability of Vt greater than L, and N, the cumulative distribution function for this quantity, will be the probability of Vt greater than L. So the more Vt, the probability of Vt greater than L is large, the more far away you are from the threshold. So this is called distance to default. Of course, it's not a distance in a straight line, it's a distance via the probability. And then you can graph the value of the default table 0 to 4. So the value of the default table 0 to 4 will be that one with S at that one, and S will be called the spread. I shall come back to spread later on. So you can compute more or less everything. So I should give that. But of course, the method model is not so tricky, quite nice, but nevertheless, there is something which is not taken into account in the method model. Assume that the value of the sum, this is capital L, the value of the sum is like that. Of course, at capital A, the firm is able to pay the capital A. But maybe the value of the firm was so big, so small before, that maybe in fact the firm didn't want to see before. And the bankruptcy of the firm occurs when the value of the firm is very small. If I assume the value of the firm is small. So if the value of the firm is very small, during a long period, as it is on my picture, I have to think that the firm has defaulted before. So in order to claim that the firm has defaulted, we can do something else, and this is the blind box model. And this is a nice model, but not useful, because there is a lot of robots. Actually, it's made to much more. So again, just think at the economic level. So you have the value of the firm. And this can be negative, but why not? And I can define the default term. This is the first time when the value of the firm is too small. And when the value of the firm is very negative, for example, or zero, the firm cannot work anymore, because the firm is no longer to pay the employer, pay the employer, the workers. So I can decide that there is some level, let me check if I am even into the level. Yes, L. L, okay. And I can say, well, when the value of the firm goes below this capital L, the firm is bankrupt. In my picture, in my computation later on, the value of the firm will be very simple for some, so we can do this. Do the picture for the next one. The bankruptcy level, the firm is into bankruptcy. Definition. So in other terms, the value of the firm will be that one, that time. The default time will be that time. So tau will be by this mission. The first time, so the first is the union, so the instrument of the D, such that the value of the firm is less or equal to capital one. If there is no such T, I should take similar choice plus affinity. The instrument of the MD7 is always plus affinity in mathematics. Plus affinity if dt is equal than n for any t. And this is a good definition. You understand the meaning of the default associated with the value of the firm. So, you will have to compute quantities relative with this default data. Now you can choose the excitation of X if tau smaller than tau, capital T smaller than tau. Right? That's the pair of X. Capital X paid only if tau is bigger than T. So in some example, you can do the computations. Not easy, because remember, I need at least the law of tau. So I need to find the law of the first acting time. This tau is called the first acting time of the convex. And this is what I claim when I told you that I'm not strong enough in mathematics. I'm able to compute the law of tau for any which. So some measures are known, very few. If V is Boolean motion, if V is geometric Boolean motion, this is known. There are some other processes that you can define the law of tau, not so much. I mean, there are processes and you can compute exactly in the closed form formula the law of tau. So then you can say, well, it's not the main problem. Do a draw approximation, compute assign the kicks or whatever you want for the law of tau, and you will be happy. No, you will not be happy. For the following reason. If the V is continuous, you have a strong signal about the occurrence of tau. So I should make a bigger picture. The same one. Under the assumption that the value of the third is continuous. You can be not happy, but for the moment, let me do this assumption. So I zoom on the boundary, that's at the level, and I something like that. And this is the value of the third. And I make the assumption. From mathematical point of view, it's a good assumption. I can observe the V, that means that at any time, I know where is V. Why not? And I would like to know when L is crossed, is eaten, for the first time. But I have a strong signal. I should look at the first time where D is the level L plus 1 over L plus 1 over L. I observe that. In front of my computer, putting this line, again, it's realistic. I can see the tau L. Oh, I wait. I can see the L plus 1 over 2L. Here. To n, and so on. So I should have a sequence to n, to 2n, and so on. And this sequence converges to that point. And the limit of to n in tau. The closer of tau I am, the less in Sorrentino, I had to invest to buy a different abode de repos. And the different abode de repos, we think I should see nothing, this never end was cost. So when I see that I'm very, very close to this level, here, see? Up here. I see, oh, there is a, of course, not a probability one, but there is a high probability that I cross the point that is very soon. And I don't want to buy this product because I'm overhand. If I use it to buy this product, it could be very, very, to buy a different type of product, it could be a very, very small price. Otherwise, I will not get steep. And this is not, you cannot calibrate this kind of model of the data. So, this is one of the reasons why this model is not very useful. There is another second reason. The second reason is what is the value of the first? So even from an economic point of view, but there are various points of view. Oh, assume that you can define the value of the first. At least it will not be difficult to move emotion. Assume that you can define the value of the first. Why not? The third reason is more realistic. The value of the firm is not a trading asset. Maybe the firm is issuing some derivative, but the value of the firm is not trading on the market. So, why to continue to do computation? In any case, this kind of model, whatever is the value of the firm, even if you make a lot of assumptions, the value of the firm is not trading. You get irrealistic number for the spread, so it's not a good model. So you can see, don't forget about the value of the firm, just try to calculate the spread, and you can do that with the jumping processes. So that the jump is not predictable. The predictable means that I can have a sequence. If I cannot approximate the tau with a sequence of times I get observed, you can see, maybe at least the model will be realistic, but I can calculate the model. If you can do that, because I'm not sure that will be able. The problem is that when there are jumps, you put the law of the truth like Newton to just something that you cannot hope, except for very, very particular cases. So this is the reason why this complex models are definitively not realistic and they are not true. Even if it produces nice computation from a mathematical point of view, they are not there yet. Maybe it goes to jumping processes. I beg you to study about that. So, you can, I think on my slide, on the notes of my web page, there are close-form formulae, but I do not command the close-form formulae for two reasons. The first one, that they are difficult to obtain, and the second one, they are still very realistic. So, the drawback of this model, again, the structure of the capital is too simple. You can do the computation only with the geometric Boolean motion where the interest rate is constant, if you have deterministic or stochastic interest rate, you can do that. The firm, the value of the firm that you traded, realistic, and to find results which are, you cannot calibrate the results. Not that good. So this is more or less the same thing. Yes, this point has been very well studied. Who defines the value of the bankruptcy? Usually, with all the models, the shareholders define the value of the bankruptcy. Is it realistic or not? I don't know. And again, this is one, and is that the credit spread? Credit spread is the difference between the interest rate and the probability of the default. I'm not good. So that's not very useful. Some developments, there are many developments. This is not again the main way that practitioners model the default. So this paper, to define the optimal boundary and so on, economic paper, they are very interesting. With random interest rates, there are a paper The specific random is territory, there is a paper by Lanfranc Schwarz. With germs, there is a famous paper by Kuhn. Well, he is able to find the first passage time for a very particular living process. For a general living process, there are a lot of studies, but it's still work in progress. This paper was not so bad. It contains an interesting idea, which is in a positive way. It contains an interesting idea, but again, you cannot calibrate this model. The interesting idea is that maybe you are too serious, telling that the bankruptcy occurs at the first time when the firm reaches a level, because it can happen this kind of thing. So this is the level. And you can imagine a model like this. The value of the firm is during a short period, a very short period, below the bankruptcy level. So if you are in such a situation, the shareholders can just decide to change the boundary and then do more bankruptcy. Or, even worse, the firm can cheat a little bit and don't declare, don't make a fully knowledge, the true value of the firm, and just as a report of the firm, they will say that they are just a little bit of the boundaries. And if you apply chapter 11, Nicole spoke about chapter 11, of the, chapter 11 is a rule for the US. Companies that when firm enter into bankruptcy like this, the firm has, I don't remember it, 7 months, pre-specified period to reorganize the firm and to go again above the boundary. So the idea of Moreau, so I should again have a zoom. The idea of Moreau was to define the value of the random of the decimal, not at the first decimal, but the first time when the firm is below the boundary level, below the bankruptcy level for a long time enough. So assume that a long time enough is needed. So I full look at the first time when the firm is below the boundary for a period of time, cumulative, not me, continuous period of time, which is 2 years, D is here. So the firm is below the boundary, but not during all the intervals, first and front, and first and front. So there is no bankruptcy. So the bankruptcy in my picture will be here. So you have to find it's more difficult the law of this time. But the problem with that model is you can still have a second structure for random time domain which will announce this time. And again, the model will spread and be not so good. There is also another paper by Crotter and the professor where they consider as well the period of time where the firm is below the boundary, but also the thickness of the path below the boundary. Maybe the value of the firm can be just below the boundary for a long time, but not deep enough to have bankruptcy. So you can do a lot of models. In any case, as soon as you are working with continuous processes, you always the same problem, the spread will achieve the calculation. Something which is, at least for me, the good model, the good model in part, but I think I got all the papers, there are not so many, would be, there is a value of the firm somewhere. The bankruptcy is the first time when the value of the firm reached some level, but the value of the firm is the credit and not observable. At least for customers. However, make some notes. So you observe the value of the verb plus some notes. So can you do something? I'm sorry if you didn't have no, except for very specific model, but it could be a good idea. The other model would be the value of the verb is not observable, but the verb is assuming some derivative, and the value of the derivative, which are correlative with the value of the verb, are observable. Okay, in some specific cases, you can do something, but of course not in the general case, so it's not interesting. There is a paper which is not here, I shall come back on that paper later on, the paper I'm using in Mondo, and this paper is considered as a main portal. Then in the vacuum, and that's the case. So the default is always the first time of the value of the firm in each modality. You don't observe the value of the firm, you observe the value of the firm, say, once by month, or the first of January, February, and so on, you get the financial report of the firm, so you know the value of the firm once by month. So you have partial information of the value of the firm. Exact information, but you don't observe the value of the firm if it's in the staff. So that's quite realistic. Okay, it can be a good idea, but there are very few examples where you can do the computation with this thing. But in some cases, you can do so. And there are not so many research papers, I think, research papers, not so many research papers. I think I would more or less all the papers. But it can be something which is interesting, except that from a mathematical point of view, we have to be to solve this kind of paper. This kind of problem. So, and I shall start today with a toy model, and I shall do mathematics now with the toy model, doing some time. Ah, I have my notation. I'm not exaggerating. Again, I have the toy model, means that I have as less hypothesis as possible. As less hypothesis as possible means that I have some interest rate. Okay, I can avoid the interest rate, but I need something to do computation. So I have a deterministic interest rate. Deterministic will just be simple. But the worst is the R stochastic. And I should have to deal with the information coming from the R. And I have the price of the default table of the default field of the zero coupon with maturity, capability, as before. And tau will be the default, and I assume, I need some hypothesis, that I know the law of tau. Again, if I don't know the law of tau, the story is ended. You can go back home. This is the minimum information I need to have the law of tau. So I suppose that I know the law of tau, and I assume that this law is smooth, that this is the derivative. F is the derivative of the law of tau. Tau is a non-negative random variable, and tau admits a density. I can avoid the density, but again, I can assume that tau is something taking values in the discrete set. I assume that this derivative is differential. This is an assumption, but not so big. And I assume also, okay, we can avoid the assumption that it will be simpler, that the code can take any value up to infinity. The tau is not bounded. But if the tau is bounded, it will create difficulties. And if the tau is bounded always smaller than capital T, the problem is fully different. So I assume that tau can occur at any time between 0 and capital T. Before doing that, I'd like to quote some anecdotes. The goal of the toy model is to produce a model where you cannot announce with the tau to n, to n, you cannot have a good forecast of what will be tau. And you can see this is fully stupid because this is the default of the firm, we have some sigma. signal and be not at home, the medium financial signal to announce the token. And the first company was trying, at least in my knowledge, the first company was trying to explain what it means, this unknown occurrence of stock was linked to insurance in the Switzerland. So with the total insurance, it seems it was in 1997, the insurance for cars. And they didn't deny that their problem with the insurance of cars, because the customer they had, the client they had, usually when the couple has car insurance, in Switzerland there are two cars, the car of the man and the car of the woman. There are two people the same insurance, and usually the fisherman, the houses are not too big, one of the car is outside at night. So the car of the man usually is inside the car. And when they are installed, the car has left. And it is strong, and it is strong in front, if you saw the tool, and they feel you not destroy the car, but here you create a big damage, so a big cost for the insurance company. So when there is a big hailstorm in some area, half of the car will die. And it puts a huge cost. And this is some event that you cannot predict. And it can be thrown or something, yes, I suggest it doesn't exist at that time, but it can be thrown or send an SMS to your customer, or take care, there will be a big hailstorm during the next hour. At that time, the SMS do not exist. And you cannot predict a storm. So this is something which you cannot predict, especially maybe you can predict a storm with a forecast, a good forecast. But you cannot predict a storm with crisis. And we are doing crisis. So with crisis, you cannot predict a storm. So what did the winter storm insurance? What is the solution for winter insurance? At least one solution is to have a buyer in your own insurance, to ask the insurer to pay more, so that the company doesn't want to bankrupt you. Not a good idea, because two women are the only insurance for cars. So you think, when you have an insurance for cars, you can design your insurance and move on to the company. Not a good idea to have a buyer to you. And they have a very good idea. Different levels of performance with very high interest rate. It was 8% at that time. At that time for Switzerland, it was something just a gift from the sky. The highest interest rate that you can have for financial products. So you pay the amount and you may receive each year the interest. 8%, you can ask for 20 years, whatever. And we receive this dividend if and only if there is no more than, I don't remember the number, say, 500 cars damaged by a hailstorm during the year. And it was fully successful. Because the interest rate was so high that a lot of people buy this product. And the first year, it was a big hailstorm, so the company would have to reimburse the 8% interest rate. And the amount of money was so large that they can reimburse all the business cars, and it was very successful. So this is a good idea to design a specific product so that they were sure that in case of a big hailstorm, they would be reimbursed. This was the idea to have a dog which comes from the blue sky, it's not so bad so bright, and very strong also coming from the blue sky. So you can imagine some different times that are not as this was. Another parenthesis. So what I should present during the next presentation, the toy model and also the Cox processing model, which are mainly used in the market, and more or less, the toe is coming from the blue sky. You cannot see and a strong signal on the market, on the prices of the market, to detect if the dog is okay or not, and so on. So nowadays, a lot of people are trying to mix the two models. Are trying to mix that kind of model and the post-process model, and trying to mix the fact that maybe there is a part of the different time that you can announce as that model of the method, and another part which is not, you cannot announce that. So, I shall continue a little bit here, because this is my control. So I look again a different type of the moon, this is again an extension. And I would like here, I do the figures, I don't know the price of these different types of the moon. I would like to guess what can be the price. And what could be the dynamic of the price, and then what I can, what can I do. So you get different types of the moon, you can call this. So this is different types of the moon, but it's one. If you do this for deformability and place delta at maturity if there is default before maturity. The delta is placed at maturity, very important. Otherwise the formula is still different. And place at maturity and not at default. So what will be the price of this default algorithm? So I apply the usual methodology. The price will be the expectation of the discounted payoff. What expectation? This is the question that you asked me. I tell you what. The manager of the firm, the bank who is selling this default algorithm will choose the probability of the default. And given the probability of the default, we are thinking the probability of default as the pricing measure, then we will use the pricing measure. And so the bank decides what is the pricing measure they are using. So this is the discounted price, the zero capital P is to discount. I should see one if two is equal to T. So this is why there is indicator function. And I should see delta, and I should tell it both this. If it has zero point, I should see delta in the other case. So this is G, and this is deterministic. So I should have probability of T smaller than tau. This is 1 minus the probability of tau smaller than T. So it will give me this quantity. That's it. So, now if I would like to have the price at time T, small T, so I should have the same payoff. But I have to take into account whether or not small t is bigger than tau or not. So if small, small t is bigger than tau, I know that the default is obvious in the past, and I know for sure that I should receive the delta at the end. So I should have this computation, and the value of the delta at t is bt capital t delta. If t is smaller than tau, I have to work a little bit. Because I still don't know if the default will occur before capital T or not. So this quantity is called the pre-default value. Pre-default because I assume that the default at time T has got a value. And what will be this quantity? It will be the expectation of the payoff, given that I have some knowledge, I have some information, so given that T is smaller than tau. And this is the only information I have. And there is no market, there is no value of the firm, there is nothing. The only information I have is whether or not it's bigger than tau or smaller than tau. So, to compute this quantity here. So I have to compute, this is basic, the conditional probability, quantity of A given B, quantity of A intersect B or the quantity of B. So I do some computation. So here I have probability of capital T smaller than tau over probability of this B, probability of T smaller than tau, plus And here today, what are the probability of this 1 and 2? And the expectation of that quantity, which is integral from small t to capital T, small t because I know that tau is greater than capital T, here. So I have the expectation of delta tau, indicator of t, smaller than tau, smaller than t. Excuse me, that is a quantity.
Formula. I have some stuff here. And